Hello everyone, so welcome to my playlist on single variable calculus. Today we are going to see the notion of extreme values of a function. So we will see the definition and we will try to understand this topic with the help of a graph and also with an example. And after that we will see a very nice theorem, which is nothing but extreme value theorem. It says that when does the extreme value exist? Okay, so it gives us the condition. So this is what the agenda is. So let's try to understand the first topic. Now suppose this is graph of some function. Okay, so as you can see, the endpoints are a and b. So this is my x-axis input and this is my y-axis, which is my f of x. So from here you can see your f is a function whose domain is what? Domain is closed a b and outputs are real number. If you want, you can take positive real numbers. So this a b can be any real number, a less than b. But yeah, so this is what we have. Now, as you can see, this is f of x. As this is a point, what will be this point? This is my f of a. So what is my p point? If I call this point as p, what is my p point? It is a comma f of a. And let me call this end point as q. So since this is b, so this will be my f of b, right? So my q point is nothing but b comma f of b. Okay, now question is, once you have a graph of a function, what is the maximum value of the function? That obviously one can ask. And what is the minimum value of the function? So from here, from the graph, you can easily see at point D, if you see, here is the topmost point. So like if, let me increase this. So this is my f of x axis. So if I call this as my f of D, then let me call this as R. So what is my R point? My R point is nothing but D comma F of D. And as you can see that F of D is the maximum value. You take any X from here, you take any X from your domain, you look its images. You look its images, it will always be less than F of D. It will always be less than or equal to F of D, because this is the topmost point. For all other, the value is less than f of d. So what I'm saying is, your let me write it over here. Your f of d is greater than or equal to f of x for all x belongs to my domain. What is my domain over here? Close interval a b. Okay, so when you have such a thing, then f of d means this value is called as the maximum value of the function f. And at which point this maximum value is occurring? It is occurring at the point d. Okay, so this is a difference. At point d, function is having the maximum value. And what is the maximum value? F of d is the maximum value. Okay, so this is one thing. And the same concept goes for the minimum also. So from the graph you can see, this is my e. So this point is what? This is my f of e. Now you take any x from here, you take any x from this domain, and you can see that its image, you take any x, its image will always be bigger than f of e, because f of e is at the bottom. So you take any x in the domain, you take its image, that will always be greater than or equal to f of e. That means what? What I'm saying is, your f of x is greater equal f of e for all x belongs to my domain. When such a scenario happens, then we say that f of e is the minimum value of the function. This is the minimum value of the function f of e. And at which point it is occurring? It is occurring at the point e. So this is the maximum value of the function and this is the minimum value of the function. And one can easily see that from the graph. You look for the topmost point and the bottommost point. So this is the definition of absolute maximum. So many times people call this as the absolute maximum or the global minimum value of the function. And this is f of e is called as the absolute minimum or the global minimum value of the function. Okay, so these are the notion of extreme values. Extreme value means maximum and minimum. But since this is over the whole interval, over the whole domain, therefore instead of calling as maximum and minimum, we call global maximum and global minimum, or absolute maximum or absolute minimum. So this is what the definition is. Okay, now don't get confused with the graph that there is only at one point you can have maximum value. It may happen that at 2-3 point you may have maximum value, but the important thing is maximum value, if exists, it is always unique, and the minimum value, if exists, is always unique. Okay, it may occur at other points, but then value will be unique. So let me demonstrate that with the help of an example. So consider this as an example. Now, as you can see, now this point is a comma f of a, this point is b comma f of b. Now, as you can see, all of them are at the one level. Okay, I hope, yes, they are at the one level. Okay, so like if this is my d, this is my h, and this is my j, then this point, at this is nothing but your f of d, this is also your f of h, and this is also your f of j. Okay, so you are having maximum value at three points, three distinct points, d, h, and j. So even though you are having maximum value at three different points, but the maximum value is unique. This is the maximum value of the function. Okay, let me call this as say capital M. So what is capital M? It is the maximum value of the function. And from the graph you can see, you take any x over here, its image will be below capital M. So therefore this is a maximum value and it is unique. Okay, so it may occur at different points, the maximum value, but the maximum value is unique. Similarly for the minimum, you can see that E and this is I. So this point is F of E, this is also my F of I. So if you take any x from here and you take the image, it will be always above this. Let me call this as small m. So your small m is less equal f of x, is less equal capital M for all x belongs to my domain. So from here you can say that this is the minimum value of the function and this is the maximum value of the function. And what is the first important point to observe? That maximum and minimum value, if exist, then it is always unique. It may occur at more than one point, but the value of the function, maximum and minimum, is always unique. Okay, now let me tell you second example, where we will see that this extreme value depends on the interval you choose. You change the interval, then extreme value may or may not exist. So let me take this example. F is from minus 2 to 2 and f of x is x cube. So if you recall the graph for x cube, it's like minus 2 and 2. So image of 2 is 8. So this is 2 comma 8. Image of minus 2 is minus 8. So this is minus 2 comma minus 8. Okay. So this is the graph of x cube. Those who don't know, they can take the help of GeoGebra. How to use that GeoGebra software? I have told you my lecture. I have told that in my lecture 1. All the links you can find in the description. But yeah, so this is the graph of the function. Now you can see at which point function is having the maximum value. At 2, function is having the maximum value. What is the maximum value of the function? 8. So f of 2 is 8. So 8 is the maximum value of the function, and at 2 it is occurring that. And you can see that f of minus 2 is minus 8. So at minus 2, function is taking the minimum value, and the minimum value is minus 8. For all other x, you can see the value lies over here. So this is the maximum and this is the minimum value. Suppose if I change the interval, suppose if I take the interval minus 2 comma infinity. So minus, from minus 2 to infinity, if I keep that. So as x goes to infinity, obviously my x cube also goes to infinity. Infinity cube is infinity. So if I change the interval for the same function, minimum value is minus 8, but there is no maximum value, because as x goes to infinity, you can see your graph goes to infinity. Okay, so as your x goes to infinity, your x cube also goes to infinity, your function. Therefore there is no maximum value, it will keep on increasing, but it has a minimum value. So you can see that as you change the interval, the minimum value is existing but not the maximum value. That's why I said earlier that this depends on the interval. Suppose if I take minus infinity to plus infinity, that means whole real number. So from here also it's going to minus infinity. So obviously as x goes to minus infinity, your x cube goes to minus infinity. That means this is going down. That means here also it is going down. So plus in, so there is no maximum value, because as x goes to infinity, graph is going towards plus infinity. As x going towards minus infinity, graph goes to minus infinity. So if this is the interval, then function has no maximum and no minimum value. Okay. And what is last left, I think? Okay, yeah. So the last is, if I take minus infinity to, that means what? There is no minimum value because graph goes to minus infinity, but the maximum value is, because I'm going till 2 only now. So this is my domain. So the maximum value is 8. Okay, so like this you can see, you change the interval, your extreme value for the function changes. So whenever there is a question on extreme values, you should always see what is the interval given. If interval is not given, you can take whole real number as the interval, but otherwise they will give you the interval and you have to check in that interval. Okay, now one can ask, okay, so like here we saw that for some interval it exists, for some interval it does not exist. So is there any condition that guarantees us that, okay, under so and so condition, your extreme value will definitely exist? Is there any condition? Yes. And the answer is the theorem. Which theorem? Extreme value theorem. It tells us a condition that under so and so condition, your extreme value will definitely exist. So let's try to see that theorem. So the theorem says that if you have a continuous function, first condition is your function has to be continuous. And second thing, your domain, this is my domain. So it should be closed interval and it should bounded. Both a and b should be finite number. So if your function is continuous and your domain is closed, closed means what? Your this endpoints are included and is bounded. Bounded means what? Your a and b both are finite real numbers. So when you have this condition on a function and this condition on domain, then the theorem says there always exists the maximum and minimum value for the function. That means what? There exists some point, say C belongs to close AB, such that at f of C you are having the maximum value, let me call it as capital M, and also there exists some small d in this interval, such that at that point function is taking the minimum value. And you take any x in this interval, then your f of x will always be between the maximum value and the minimum value. Right, because this is the maximum value and this is the minimum value. So you take any other x in this domain, then it will always lie between the smallest and the largest one. So extreme values is guaranteed under this condition. Converse is not true. If you have any example, you can post that in the comment section. Okay, so if the function is continuous and the domain is closed and bounded, then extreme values are always attained. It may happen that extreme values are obtained, but this may not satisfy. So I'm saying the converse is not true. So the homework for this session is, you have to give me an example of a function which has extreme value, but it is violating one of the condition, either this or this or this. Okay, so converse is not true. So I'm not going to give you an example. So yeah, that's why this theorem is very important. It tells you that under continuity and the closed and boundedness of a domain, your extreme value always exists. So I hope this session is clear to you. If you have any doubt regarding this, you can ask me in the comment section. And if everything is clear, then do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.